Welcome back, students. In the last video, we were discussing about transaction exposure. So we'll solve one more problem on transaction exposure. Look at the slide which has been displayed on the video. I'll read out the main key points. Here's a corporation called DC. It's a US-based software consultant. They are specialized in financial software for several Fortune 500. It has an office in India, US, UK, Europe, as well as in Australia. In 2002, DC Corporation required pound 1 lakh. Its exposure is pound 1 lakh. 1 lakh for 180 days. It had four options. Okay. The first option is basically the forward market hedge, money market hedge, option hedge, and lastly, no hedge. Its analyst developed the following information, which was used to assess the alternative solution. For this DC Corporation, spot rate is dollar by pound is equal to 1.50, current spot rate, and 180 days forward rate is, forward rate what they are given is dollar by pound is 1.48. Interest rate they are given, interest rate 180 days deposit rate they have given, as well as 180 days borrowing rate they have given for both for US and UK. The company also had the following information available to it. A call option on pound that expires in 180 days has an exercise price, or you can call it a strike price. Strike price of $1.5 per pound and a premium of 0.02. The future spot rate in 180 days are forecast as follows. That is possible outcomes. They have given three possible outcomes, and then they have given the probability, that is 20%, 60%, as well as 20% they have given. An analysis of hedging technique should be made and advise DC Corporation on the best alternative for hedging. Yes, come back. This is the question what they are given. So based on this question, we have to find the alternative strategies. The first strategy is forward hedge. Forward market hedge. So in case of forward market hedge, so as we know that the exposure, total exposure is pound 1 lakh for 180 days. Okay. So this is the exposure what we have. So with this exposure, we have to find out the, what is the forward rate for this. Okay. To meet this obligation, DC Corporation has to enter forward contract at 1.48 per pound. This is what they are given, that is dollar by pound. As per the forward rate, dollar by pound is equal to 1.48. Okay. So therefore, one pound is equal to $1.48, and we have exposure of 1 lakh pound. If you cross multiply it, we'll get the answer. If we simplify this one, we'll get the answer. The answer is $1,48,000. This is the exposures in terms of dollar when you go for a forward market hedge.
Second one is money market hedge.
In case of money market hedge, as we know, total exposure, total payable is 1 lakh. Okay. This 1 lakh what do? Total amount payable.
The first step one is we need to find out what is total amount payable. Total amount payable is 1 lakh.
Total amount payable is pound 1 lakh.
So then step 2, what you do? We'll come to present value. Present value of pound 1 lakh. Okay, that is equal to.
So we have to convert present value, as we know that the borrowing rate and lending rate is 4.5% as well as 5.1%. 4.5% as well as 5.1%. That is, this is the deposit rate.
Deposit rate, this is the borrowing rate.
So here what we are doing, if I deposit how much money, that become 1 lakh after 180 days. That's what we are finding out.
So here what you do, the 4.5 is for per annum. We have to convert for the 3 months. 4.5 into
6 by 12. If you do that, we'll get a 0.025.
So if you convert, if you want to convert, means 1 lakh divided by 1 plus 0.025,
the answer what we get is 97,799.51. Okay, so step 4 what we do, step 3 what we do is
we'll convert this is the amount if we invest today, this will become 1 lakh rupees after 180 days. Now if we convert this pound 97,799.51 into dollars.
So at the rate of 1.48 spot rate, you have to consider spot rate
dollar by pound. That means 1 pound is equal to 1.48 dollar.
1 pound is equal to 1.48 dollar. We have how much pound? We have
97,799.51. If you calculate, if you cross multiply it, we'll get the answer. So 97,799.51 into 1.48.
So answer what we get is 1,44,743.3. This is the amount at the beginning of today's value is 1,44,743.3. Now what we have to do? So this amount we are going to be investing, will be borrowing for a 6 months. Okay.
Step 4.
If you borrow for 180 days, what is the answer would you get? I'll solve it over here.
Borrowing rate is 5.1% into, or I'll simply 5.1 divided by 100 into 6 by 12.
The answer what we get is 1,48,434. In some books they are taken annual value, that's wrong. You should not take the annual value. To summarize the money market hedge, again I'll repeat. So first, amount payable is 1 lakh. This 1 lakh when you are paying after 180 days, the amount what you are supposed to pay after 180 days will convert into present value. When we convert into present value, I have taken 4.5%. This is the amount at which we are going to deposit. This I am converting into 6 months. Okay. So, that's 1 lakh divided by 1 plus 0.025 will get a 97,799.51 pound. This is the value, today's value of pound. This is the amount of value that we are going to pay, that we are supposed to pay today. Okay. If I convert that pound in dollar, the amount what we get is 1,44,743.3. Okay. And if I invest this dollar, what we get, if I park this money at rate of 5.1%, the final amount what you get is 1,48,434. In other way, what you can call, if I borrow this 1,44,743.3 at rate of 5.1, so end the principal and interest together, I am supposed to pay 1,48,434. This is the amount which you are supposed to pay if you go for money market hedge. To make the things very simple, if I borrow 1,48,434, that is, if I borrow today 1,44,743, okay, for 6 months the amount will become 1,44,434. Okay, if this I convert into present value, this will become 1,44,743.3, and this 1,44,743, if I convert into pound, amount that will become a 97,799 pound today. This, if I am going to calculate for 180 days, so it will become a 1 lakh. Okay. In simple, I'll show you one simple step here. This is the only thing you have to understand. Step 1, what you are supposed to do? Here, 1 lakh, the amount you are supposed to pay. Okay. This we have to convert to present value. If you convert to present value, how much will get? 799.51. This again you convert to dollar. If you convert to dollar, you will get a 1,44,743.3. Again, if you borrow this money for at the rate of 5.1%, so amount what you are supposed to pay is 1,48,434. This completes the money market hedge. And next we'll move to the, after this money market hedge, we'll move to the option hedge. We'll move to the option hedge. They again possible outcomes. They again possible outcome. They have given and probable. This one premium. Premium per unit. Okay. Then option. Then followed by total price paid, probability. If I take possible outcomes, dollar 1.44, dollar 1.46. and dollar 1.53. Okay. Outcome premium per unit.
possible outcome. Premium is 0.02. Okay. So option, here we are not using the option. Here we are exercising. We'll opt the option, and then total price paid. Here 1.44 is there. Premium amount is 0.2, 0.02. That is 1.44 plus 0.02 will become 1.
How much will you have? 1.46.
Okay, 1.46 multiplied by your payment exposure is 1 lakh. Okay, that comes to 1,46,000. That is 1.46 into 1 lakh will get a 1,46,000. The probability of getting this chance is 20%. Second one is 1.46 plus 2, that is 1.48. 1.48 into 1 lakh. Okay, so we will get a 1,48,000.
And lastly, the option price, what they are giving is, let me read the option price that is there in the problem, just check it out. Option price, what they are giving is 1.5. Okay, so 1.5 is the option price plus 0.02, 1 lakh. The strike price, what they are given is 1.5, they are given 1.5, they are given strike price. Strike price in the problem they are given as a 1.5 plus PM 0.02. So here we are exercising the option. In these two cases, the option price what they are given is 1.5. Here it is 1.44 plus 0.02. It is 1.46. It is lesser than the option price. So better not to exercise the option. That is, option is going to lapse here. In this case, 1.46 plus 0.02, 1.48. So again, it is lesser than the option price. So better not to exercise the option. In this case, it is 1.53 is there. The quoted price 1.53, whereas option price, they are given option of 1.5. It is better to exercise the option. That is, you are going to opt the option. So 1.5 plus this one, your premium price is, premium per unit 0.02. 1.5 plus 0.02 comes to 1.52 multiplied by 1 lakh, you get a 1,50,000. The probability is they are going to 20%, 60% and 20% total 100%. Okay. So we need to find the probability of exercising the call option. The probability of exercising call option is only 20%. So in this case, we are not exercising call option. In this case, we are not exercising call option. So only the last case we are exercising the call option. So the probability of exercising the call option is just only 20%. Okay. Moving ahead. So valuation of this call option, if you want to do the valuation of this call option or expected value payable using option is, basically, so we can see a 20% possibility that we may have 1,46,000. Then 60% probability that the value may 1,48,000. And lastly, 20% probability that we may go for 1,52,000. Okay. If you add all these things, the resultant answer what you get is $1,48,000. If you go for option, the value what you get is 1,48,000. To summarize option again, the option value, the strike price in the option what they are doing is 1.5. If it is more than 1.5, the investor will will access the option. If it is lesser than 1.5, nobody will access the option. Okay. In this scenario, in the first case, it is 1.44. Obviously, we are not accessing the option. The value will become 1.44 plus 0.02 will become 1.46 multiplied by exposure is 1 lakh. We'll get a 1,46,000. Similarly, here 1.48 into 1 lakh will get a 1,48,000. And here the price what they have mentioned is 1.53, but the strike price what we are having is 1.5. Now it is better to exercise the option. Okay. When we exercise the option, 1.5 plus 0.02 it become 1.52 into 1 lakh, we'll get a 1,52,000. Okay. If you do the valuation of this one, we'll get a 1,48,000. The last option. Is our last strategy is no hedge, or if you don't do any hedge, what is the possible answer? The next option is D, that is no hedge. Expected spot rate, we are finding out the no hedge, no expected for spot rate, we need to find out $1.44, $1.46, and $1.53. And what is the probability of getting these things? Probability of getting this thing is 0.2, 0.6, and 0.2 again. Okay. If you multiply these two, x, I can say p, I'll write xp, okay. Answer what we get is 0.288, 0.876 and 0.306. If you total it, we'll get a $1.470. This is the expected price or expected price as per the when it doesn't go for any sort of hedging. Okay. So here the future value is or you can call expected value under no hedge. Expected value under no hedge is basically 1.470 is the price and exposure is 1 lakh. So we will get a $1,47,000. So to summarize, no hedge. So we have three possible outcomes are there and their probability. If you add all these things, we will get a $1.470 as the expected price. This expected price multiplied by our exposure, we get a 1,47,000. This is as per the no hedge. To summarize the entire four thing, the first one is we discussed about forward market hedge. So forward market hedge, what the answer we got? Just go back and just check it out. What the answer we got? It is basically 1,48,000. Money market hedge, so money market hedge, if you check the money market hedge, we get 1,48,434. Okay, then option hedge. If you go for option hedge, it is 1,48,400. Your option hedge is 1,48,400. And lastly,
no hedge. If you go for no hedge, the answer is 1,47,000 dollar. All is in a. So if you consider all these things, in case of your no hedge, the value is the less amount which you are paying among all the thing is by going with the no hedge. So the strategy should be the company should not go for any hedge. If they doesn't go for any hedge, means the amount which you are supposed to pay is in terms of US dollar is 1,47,000. That's complete this problem.